Hello students, I am your instructor Dr. Shelter Sharma, assistant professor from Indian Institute of Tourism and Travel Management. Welcome back to the course on destination management. We bring this course to you as a part of e-Pathshala initiative of the Ministry of Human Resource Development, Government of India, to make postgraduate education accessible to all. In the last module, we established the importance of the DMOs for management and sustainable development of a destination. We have studied about destination management organizations, DMOs, and the different types. There you have got a good understanding about what are the various kinds of DMOs and how do they manage destinations. The last module has also described that how destination management and indeed the development takes place. In this module, we discuss the roles of a DMO. We begin with the discussion on the role of a destination and then we move on to discuss the role of a DMO and how do they develop the destination. What is the internal destination development? What is the external marketing development? How DMOs fulfills the basic requirements of their destination? These questions will be answered in this module. Additionally, this module will give you some practical insights and information related to the roles of DMOs. We will also discuss the roles of destinations, destination managers and planners. A tourism destination has two essential functions and some supporting roles. Out of these, the first and leading role is that it must seek to enhance the social and economic well-being of the residents who live within its boundaries. The second role is it must provide the improvement of resident well-being by offering a range of activities and experiences involved of the kind that we identify as tourism experiences. There are many people who viewed of destination management organizations, the DMOs, as destination marketing organizations. By reading this module, you will be able to understand two main activities of DMOs. The M can be considered as either management or commercialization, external destination marketing, EDM function, and the internal destination development, IDD function. This module conceptualizes and describes EDM and IDD are their respective activities. The detailed model based on these two primary functions is presented. The provision of this range of activities and experiences when enjoyed by the visitor at a price which they are willing to pay. It enables the destination to operate in a sustainable manner, economic, environmental, social and cultural, to the benefits of residents, might be regarded as success at the destination. Students, one of the pioneers in the field of destination management and marketing, Gartrell has identified following five areas of activity for more specific roles of DMOs. 1. The coordination of many constituent elements of the tourism sector, including local community, political, civic and travel industry representatives, so as to achieve a single voice of tourism development. 2. The fulfillment of both a leadership and advocacy role for tourism within the local community that its services. The DMO should be visible entity that draws attention to tourism so that residents of the destination understand the significance of the travel and tourism industry. 3. Helping to ensure the development of an attractive set of tourism facilities, events and programs and an image that will help position and promote the destination. 4. Assisting visitors through the provision of visitor service such as pre-visit information and additional information upon arrival. And 5. The DMOs also has another important role, serving as a key liaison to assist external organizations such as meeting planners, tour wholesalers, tour operators and travel agents who are working to bring visitors to the destination. Summarizing above, in the broader terms, three roles of DMOs are to work towards enhancing the well-being of destination residents. Second, to ensure that visitors are offered visitation experiences that are at minimum price, highly satisfactory and highly memorable. And third, to ensure the provision of effective destination management and stewardship. UNWTO in the year 2004 defines DMOs as the organizations responsible for the management and or marketing of destinations. Ritchie and Crouch advocate the transition of the M in DMO to refer to management rather than marketing because the role of DMOs has strengthened and spread, as destinations have attempted to play a more proactive role in nurturing and managing the benefits of tourism development. Morrison, Bruin and Anderson have pointed out five primary roles of a DMO. 1. An economic driver generating new income, employment and taxes, contributing to a more diversified local economy. 2. A community marketer, communicating the most appropriate destination image, attractions and facilities to selected visitor markets. 3. An industry coordinator, providing a clear focus and encouraging less industry fragmentation so as to share in the growing benefits of tourism. 4. A quasi public representative, adding legitimacy for the industry and protection to individual and group visitors. And 5. A builder of community pride by enhancing the quality of life and acting as a chief flag carrier for residents and visitors alike. Prasanna, Shrinan and Ritchie in the year 2005 suggested that activities of DMOs may be classified into two functions. First, external marketing development, EMD, and second, internal destination development, IDD. The conceptual model described herein builds on the notions of the common and desired activities of the DMOs as presented earlier, but describes them as contributing to one of these two key functions. Each function of the DMO may be viewed as an amalgamation of specific activities. Students, let us discuss them one by one. First, it is the external marketing development, EMD. These operational marketing activities have been drawn from the literature related to destination management. They are put in place after the premeditated marketing activities of image definition, branding and positioning have been completed. Practically, the EDM function is meant to include all activities aimed at attracting tourists to the destination. The specific activities were chosen to be as comprehensive and frugal as possible. Thus, these activities have an outward orientation in that their aim is to influence the actions of persons outside the destination. Recognizing that marketing entails much more than just selling or advertising destination, promotion is usually the DMO's major activity and budget item. Towards this end, after developing a marketing plan, the DMO can use different promotion tools. These tools can be personal selling, direct marketing, advertising, sales promotion, publicity and public relations. Though the selling of the tourism products and services of a destination may be primarily done by the stakeholders, individual firms, these firms' stakeholder are offering the tourist and travel trade for the reasons of efficiency and effectiveness. The DMOs can still be viewed as managing the selling of a destination as a whole in the greater sense. Common activities offered by the DMOs include attending shows, exhibitions and cultural events, familiarization tours for the meeting and incentive planners and travel writers, and tourist information centers, kiosks. According to Dorr and Crouch, in the year 2003, publicity through advertising is one of the necessary tools of promotion, which utilizes various media. Advertising for tourists uses print, satellite, television, radio, outdoor, hoardings, and of now internet media. Whereas trade advertising occurs in specific travel trade magazines, newsletters in the plane and newspapers, it appears that the use of direct promotion methods has increased as destinations have turned to the direct mail of the destination brochures, leaflets, flyers or visitor guides magazines. It has also encouraged the use of global distribution systems and destination web pages to facilitate direct communication and bookings. Additionally, important to note that it is word of mouth advertising, which is spontaneously generated by previous visitors to the destination. The DMOs utilizes main publicity techniques are specific events, speeches, news, brochures and written materials. They involve information from an outside source used by the news media based on its news value. In contrast, Public relations is a much wider concept as it encompasses a greater range of activities for building relationships with the organization's various stakeholders by obtaining favorable publicity, building up a good corporate image, which in turn handle or head off unfavorable rumors, stories and events. Sales blitz at travel industry trade shows can be very helpful in building relationships between the DMOs and different suppliers of tourism products and services at the destination. Cooperative programs go a long way in blending the DMO and the hospitality community into a unified marketing presence. They develop mutual respect and indebtedness regarding the need of each, maximizing membership and participation in destination exposure. Web marketing, digital marketing is shown as the largest component of the destination marketing wheel of EMD because of its growing importance and an effective and efficient method of communicating marketing and other messages to stakeholders. Table on your screen summarizes the 8 core functions of the website of a DMO. The development of e-commerce has led to greater changes in the way tourists relate to the tourism industry. Likewise, there has been a creation of new virtual marketplaces with the advent of the internet extending beyond the traditional physical tourism marketplaces. There are 8 main functions of a DMO website. First function is the general publicity. It provides a basic web presence, interaction and supporting information. The second is advertising the product and the services. The website publishes the local tourism products and or services without prices. Third is providing the price information. The website may provide price information for the local tourism products and services. Next function is to handle the email inquiries. The website provides email addresses to allow customers to make inquiries about the web page, products and services and so on. Another important function is to facilitate the booking. It enables customers to make online bookings. Sixth function of the website is to provide for a payment gateway also. The site provides for payments through debit and or credit cards for the online shopping of tourism products like museum tickets, day tours, accommodations, inter-city travel, transfers, etc. It is important to identify the customers and visitors to the site so as to remain in touch with them. The seventh function of the site is to register the visitors with an ID. Then the websites can be used for other functions as well, like calling for information, tourism guide services, etc. Increasingly, tourism officials and providing products and services online, resulting in more customers getting destination information and booking accommodation through the internet. Based on an extended model of e-commerce adoption, 3 stages in developing profitable websites may be identified. 1. Promotion. 2. Provision and processing. And 3. Moving from simple static promotion to full-fledged e-commerce applications. The other important functions of a DMO is internal destination development, IDD. IDD may be viewed as encircling all other forms of activity apart from marketing undertaken by the DMOs to develop and maintain tourism and destination. The function of destination development is internal as the activities are aimed at internal initiatives to the destination. Many of the activities need the action and resources of other destination stakeholders. In these areas, the DMOs mainly helps to coordinate the deployment of resources rather than actually deploying their own resources. The most important aspects of IDD are shown in figure 2 and described as being effectively achieved through the DMO's critical skill of coordinating tourism stakeholders. It is suggested that ultimately the ability to execute the destination management role will be determined by the DMO's ability to coordinate these stakeholders. The main competency of stakeholder coordination must effectively mobilize and deploy resources to achieve positive outcomes in 6 areas. Have a look at the figure on your screen. Shihan and Ritchie in the year 2005 has revealed that DMOs have an extensive range of stakeholders with a high potential for cooperation. These stakeholders also have some potential to threaten the ability of DMO to achieve its objectives. For deciding the diverse set of interests, this information is critical in helping understand DMOs as conveners. A total of 32 tourism stakeholders were identified. The most important ones, according to a DMO executives, were hotels, government at different levels, attractions, board of directors of the DMO and the convention center, DMO members, civil authorities, tour guides, tour escorts, travel agencies, tour operators, event managers, public and private monument authorities, residents, restaurants, universities and colleges, souvenir shops, sellers, the local chamber of commerce and sponsors. A stakeholder for tourism is defined as any entity that is influenced by or that can affect the success of the destination management activities as performed by the DMO. Coordinating tourism stakeholders and pairing them in a ranch appears at the center of the model. It is considered to be the most essential skill performed by the DMO in achieving success in the several dimensions of IDD. It is only through safeguarding the cooperation of numerous stakeholders that the DMO can mobilize the resources necessary to be more effective. Therefore, an important evaluation of the DMO ability to foster IDD will be directly related to the number and quality of relationships with the stakeholders. During this condition, network analysis can be used to determine the strength of the DMO's position in the network along with the density of the network. Coordination and integration of stakeholders, which is a sound core competency of the DMO, must establish a substance for its IDD efforts. This integration may be done by providing sound visitor management and information research. This foundation is something that can be built primarily around the initiative and resources of the DMOs. From this substance, it is possible to develop the other dimensions of IDD, which is the quality of the visitor experience, human resource development, finance and venture capital, resource stewardship and crisis management, etc. This may be implemented by other stakeholders rather than the DMO directly. Both EDM and IDD multifold responsibilities are therefore to other sum of efforts of the multiple activities. For your basic understanding, the table on your screen has summarized the core activities of DMOs, which are categorized under either EDM or IDD. Students, so during this discussion, we have learned that our tourism destination has two principal important roles and some supporting roles. From them, first and leading role is it must seek to enhance the social and economic well-being of the resident who live within its boundaries. The second role is it must provide this improvement of resident well-being by offering a range of activities, events and experiences of the kind that we identify as tourism experiences. DMOs may be classified into two functions. First, external marketing development, EMD, and second, internal destination development, IDD. Functionally, the EDM function is meant to include all activities aimed at attracting tourists to the destination. IDD may be viewed as encompassing all other forms of activity apart from marketing undertaken by the DMOs to develop and maintain tourism at destination. The function of destination development is internal as the activities are aimed at internal initiatives to the destination. Many of the activities need the action and resources of other destination stakeholders. That is all for now. We will discuss a related concept of destination management companies in the next module. Thank you.